Our next disaster movie features a bloodthirsty beast with balls the size of planets.
Lady Gaga?
No, it's the Predator, you know.
How have you got a girlfriend and I haven't?
In this memorable scene, Arnold covers himself in mud to try and hide from the violent alien Predator's heat-seeking vision. Watching the Predator's thermal images, we're left in suspense, unable to tell if he can see Arnold or not. And the combination of threat and violence, a very simple plan, and the sight of Arnold's muscles glistening in the moonlight gives Arnie one of his finest moments.
Oh, so he hid from a technologically advanced and unimaginably violent alien by standing right in front of him with mud smeared on his pecs.
Yep, apparently so. Let's hope the Predator attacks when Glastonbury's on, eh?
Because it's muddy, it's wet. Surviving in a disaster movie often means avoiding being detected by the bad guys. That's why today, I've worn my stealthy jumper. But if the bad guys have the unfair advantage of futuristic thermal technology, would covering yourself in mud prevent you from being found? And if getting muddy doesn't work, how else would you survive? I'm gonna ask this guy for all the answers.
He works at one of the world's leading thermal imaging companies, and he can see things that ordinary people can't.
In the film Predator, the alien has this kind of weird, colory eyesight thing. What is that all about?
The Predator itself has a thermal imager. The huge advantage of thermal imaging is that you can see in the dark. And so that's what's giving the Predator his edge.
So everything you see on the screen there is just heat.
So I can see the cameraman there.
Even through his clothing, he shows up very clearly against the background because he's simply a completely different heat from his surroundings.
In the film, Arnold Schwarzenegger covers himself in mud to hide away from Predator's thermal imaging eyes. Is that something that would actually work?
No, not at all.
If you smear yourself in mud, your body temperature will warm it up and dry it out, and it won't make any difference. You'll just look as hot as you did before.
Jez says that the movie Predator is wrong, but I want proof. And to get it, I'm prepared to cover my weedy torso in mud to see if I can remain undetected.
What's that smell? Oh, it's me.
Let's see whether Arnie would really have survived that terrifying ordeal.
Well, you are not invisible, but there's no way that you would ever hide from a thermal imaging camera by doing that.
So if a Predator alien came down to Earth,
You'd be dead.
I'd be dead.
Yes.
I'd be dead, unless it's a Predator with fairly bad eyesight.
So Jez was right, and the movie Predator was wrong. You can't use mud to hide from a heat-seeking alien. But what could I do if I'm stuck in the jungle being hunted down by a thermal imaging-eyed monster?
What you need to do is find a solid barrier which is going to shield the heat coming from your body back to the camera. It could be a household material, cardboard, cover it in tinfoil, for example.
Why tinfoil?
Well, tinfoil is a reflective substance that'll reflect the heat from the surrounding areas back at the camera, thereby shield you. My only concern with that is that the edges of the tin foil are going to stand out quite prominently against the background. Try putting some branches on it to try and break up the shape of the barrier so that you fit in and are slightly more camouflaged against the background.
So to really hide from a heat-seeking alien, you need some cardboard, tin foil and foliage to make a thermal imaging barrier that blends you into your jungle surroundings.
Arnold Schwarzenegger in the film went through a village at one point. They look like they maybe have had some sort of convenience store. Maybe go to one of those, pick up some tinfoil, cardboard box.
So I do what Arnie should have done. Nip down the convenience store for some bits. And once I've covered my cardboard in tinfoil to reflect the heat and used foliage to camouflage the edge of my barrier, I am good to go.
It's done. Time to put it to the test. I'm going to play a game of hide and seek. I'm going to give you 100 seconds to count. I'm going to go and hide somewhere behind my barrier. Then you have to find me, and if you can't see me within a minute, then I have lived long enough to become the governor of California.
Fair enough.
3, 2, 1,
go! 1, 2.
I haven't got long to find somewhere to prop up my makeshift thermal barrier.
34, 35, 36.
But I found a cluster of trees to give myself almost 360 degrees of protection from the Predator.
61, 62, 63.
I've just got time to add some extra foliage to make sure it blends in with the surrounding heat patterns.
81, 82, 83...
I hope I'll be back!
97, 98, 99, 100.
Here we go. Jez can only use his camera to see. He is the predator and I am his prey. Jez is looking for colour discrepancies in the heat signature of the woodland to try and find me.
Even if he can't see me, I also can't see him, so I have no idea where he is. I could just hear his footsteps. It's quite scary.
He's very close, and unfortunately, I've got a bit of a tickle in my throat. He sounds like he's getting closer. Let's just hope my heat signature isn't going to give me away.
Still alive, which means my barrier of truth is working.
The 60 seconds is up! Did you see me?
No, I didn't.
Come on! Yes! I survived the predator!
I have done it! Now I can get to the chopper! Let's recap the facts.
You can't hide from the predator by caking yourself in mud. He'd find you, skin you, and string you up. To survive, Arnie should have just gone down to the local newsagents, got some tinfoil, some cardboard, and made a reflective barrier. And if all else fails, just dress as a sexy lady predator.
Look what I've done with my hair!
That's how you survive being detected by a heat-seeking alien in a disaster movie. Now all you have to worry about is Predator 2, Alien vs. Predator, Alien vs. Predator Requiem, Predators, Predator vs. Pokemon...